full day today, and I thank everyone who participated and who stayed with us and joined all three sessions. Today we actually heard ways where we can collaborate, ways where we can actually get resource funding for our resource project, for our research projects. So in the morning, our first session, we heard from Dr. El Mapo. Manjeni told us about the Horizon 2020 and all the funding that EU makes available for all of us. Should we be interested to submit a proposal? And also we heard from Ms. Lim that APEC also makes available to all of us this initiative so that we can actually fund our research projects, our workshops and symposiums. After Ms. Lim's presentation, we heard a possible way for us to collaborate on providing the information that we get when we attend APEC senior officials meetings. Mela has explained very precisely, EIDS is not able to attend all SOM meetings. In fact, this year we only had one, and it's not even me who went to Papua New Guinea. So, and because of that, we really had to rely on everyone's participation and collaboration, and also cooperation, because even hearing the stories from DFA, they would tell us that if nobody from the Philippines is going to attend a meeting, they would have to attend it themselves. And can you imagine one person attending one meeting after another and trying to familiarize themselves with all the acronyms and the special issues? So it's really very difficult. And then we will, after maybe 18 years, we will host again APEC. And we have to build up again the information. So maybe now we can just keep on trying to build the information that's already available. Little by little, but 1 year at a time, then eventually we'll have a database. So my closing remarks is really, what we heard today are ways where we can actually collaborate, work together, and maybe just a little bit, just by doing a little bit, we can actually help our country. So thank you very much.